Welcome to the 95th episode in our AI and You podcast series. Today's Monday, September 6th, 2022, and I'm your host, Vikar Saidi. I'm a computer scientist and engineer, a lecturer, and a consultant. I'm also the author of several books. My most recent book is about artificial intelligence and is titled The Genome Affair. The Genome Affair is a speculative work. It examines what the world might be like if some of the more extraordinary capabilities forecast to be realized in AI over the next 20 to 30 years were actually realized today. Given the growing list of frightening existential threats humankind now faces, the book pays particular attention to the impact AI is expected to have on world affairs. The book is available in ebook format for those who prefer to read on a digital device, but it's also available in a high-quality paperback edition. The Genome Affair is available on Amazon, so I hope you'll take the time to read it and to leave a review. Amazon book reviews are very helpful for writers. I'm very interested in how science and technology influence world affairs and the big questions facing humankind. Studying at the confluence of the great disciplines of human history, political science and thought, international affairs, science and technology offers a deep understanding and pedagogically important lessons of how advances in human endeavor have influenced and impacted civilization. I'm available to give talks on artificial intelligence and its related technologies, and on the impact AI is expected to have, or is already having, on our world. If you'd like to get in touch with me to arrange a web-based event or consulting meeting with your company or organization, you can find my contact info in the podcast notes below. Please make sure to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and share it with others if you find the content valuable. Thank you. And now, on to today's podcast. In our last podcast, episode 94, I spoke about how China uses AI to eradicate intolerance in their society. In today's podcast, episode 95, I'll speak about irrationality and intolerance, humankind's two greatest liabilities in the age of AI. Let's get started. 12,000 years have passed since humankind abandoned life as hunter-gatherers, a nomadic lifestyle that characterized us and numerous other species of hominins for countless millennia. The retreat of the Ice Age and subsequent melting of glaciers, the formation of fertile river valleys, and a genetic mutation in wheat that now kept the grains on the stalk rather than scattering them across fields every time the wind blew, triggered the agricultural revolution and hastened humankind's transition to life in settlements, villages, towns, and cities. But since the birth of civilization in Mesopotamia, only 20 or so of the world's 200 sovereign polities, nation-states or city-states, including America, Australia, Austria, Canada, Denmark, Finland, France, Germany, Italy, Japan, Norway, Singapore, South Korea, Spain, Sweden, Switzerland, Taiwan, the UK, and the US have managed to reach the apex of human achievement, a point where sovereign nations and nation states can be considered advanced, peaceful, and prosperous. These polities are characterized by well-developed and high-functioning government and non-governmental institutions, including best-in-class executive, legislative, and judicial branches of government with the power to check one another, a free and independent press, along with world-class and innovative academic, medical, scientific, and technological institutions, as well as industrial organizations. Within the constellation of nations and polities that have reached the apex in our era, civil society thrives, as do numerous other institutions and literary societies. This constellation is also characterized by a robust presence in the arts and humanities, which results in cultural contributions that enrich the citizens of their respective domestic polity. Many of these institutional benefits frequently permeate cultural and physical barriers and official borders around the globe, and in this way, they further enrich all of humankind. An extraordinary example is the rapid development in America and the European Union of vaccines and therapies to combat the COVID-19 coronavirus. Today, most of humankind has been vaccinated twice, thrice, and in some cases, four times, using messenger RNA platform vaccines or more traditional vaccines. Such an episode is unparalleled in human history. America and the European Union have literally saved humankind. And it illustrates what is possible when ethical, responsible individuals occupy leadership roles at the helm of the world's leading liberal democracies. But why is it that out of 200 or so distinct polities that make up today's world, only 10% have been able to develop economically and socially to a sufficient degree such that they exclusively constitute the rarefied constellation of nations at humankind's apex, whilst the rest of the world endlessly struggles? Perhaps the causes vary widely across cultures, geographies, and societies, and perhaps their unique historical journey also plays a significant role in limiting their progress. Certainly, there is no limitation in their cognitive ability. There is no empirical or scientific evidence of that. Rather, it is most likely that such endemic and metastatic failure rests in their culture. Specifically, it seems we can identify two attributes that appear to be present in virtually every aspirational yet struggling polity and society, namely the endemic, pervasive, and ubiquitous presence of irrationality and intolerance amongst the citizenry. The hallmark of a modern society or civilization found amongst a constellation of nations who have reached the apex is an awesome and solemn respect for the institutions described above, and the establishment, cultivation, and unflinching support for these institutions, come what may. Crucially, the establishment and nurturing of these institutions requires a rational and tolerant citizenry. If the citizens of a polity cannot tolerate the diversity within their society, clan, ethnicity, provinciality, race, religion, sect, sexual minorities, tribes, etc., then they will be unable to trust one another. And if they cannot trust one another, they have invariably and unwittingly precluded their ability to work together. They will be unable to cooperate. For the past 70,000 years, flexible, large-scale cooperation has emerged as humankind's superpower. Following this cognitive revolution, sapiens jumped from being in the middle of the food chain, a place they had occupied for the previous 200,000 years, to the very top through cooperation. Humankind erected the pyramids of Giza on the west bank of the River Nile in Egypt. The Great Pyramid of Khufu stands today at 500 feet in height. It contains 2.5 million blocks of stone, with each block weighing approximately 2.5 tons. This pyramid was constructed during Khufu's lifetime, circa 2500 BCE, approximately 4500 years ago. It is humankind's earliest example of flexible, large-scale, awe-inspiring, and unprecedented cooperation. On July 20, 1969, America sent a group of men to the surface of the moon for a brief walkabout. This Apollo mission, and each subsequent mission, took about 7 years to initially plan, and at its inception, the project was considered impossible. NASA officials complained that they simply did not have the scientific and technological capabilities to achieve such a goal. They said America currently had no idea how to fulfill President Kennedy's grand ambition. But through the unprecedented cooperation of 20,000 American companies, the nation's leading universities, and 400,000 employees, the mission was a success. Large-scale, flexible cooperation enables us to establish well-functioning institutions. And these institutions are the calling card, the hallmark, the defining characteristic of the constellation of nations who have risen to humankind's apex. These institutions and the individuals who populate them are capable of untold achievement. But the prerequisite of establishing such institutions is a society that is rational and that has overcome endemic intolerance. Consistently and unequivocally, intolerance leads to distrust, and distrust precludes our ability to work together, our ability to cooperate. Together, we now live in an age where fourth industrial revolution, science and technology, including artificial intelligence, biotechnology, computing, both quantum and super, data science, and an increasing capacity to intervene in human intellectual and physical capacity through these disciplines is opening a chasm between the nations within the constellation at the apex and those without. These extraordinary sciences and technologies are increasingly infiltrating virtually every aspect of modern life. And those societies that are unable to overcome their endemic, pervasive, and ubiquitous irrationality and intolerance are likely facing a predictably bleak future. It is the work of statesmen and women everywhere to alert their citizens to the consequences that await them and to try to effect change. The people must learn that awaiting and praying for messiahs is not the solution. Overcoming irrational behavior and intolerance is. Thank you for spending some time with me. I'm trying to follow the TED Talk format, and so I'm keeping these podcasts under 20 minutes. Let me know what you think. I hope you'll find these insights into artificial intelligence helpful, and I hope you'll read my new book, The Genome Affair. It's on Amazon. Until next time, then, this has been the AI and You podcast with author Vikar Saidi.